Well, hello there, fine folks. I need to move my OBS window here a little bit. We are going to go into a little bit of a dive of... Is Ubuntu pointless? Quote from Chris Titus Tech 2022. Ubuntu is pointless. Crazy person. Let's look at is Ubuntu pointless. I'm running Ubuntu 20.04 with a customized, or with a customized, I themed the desktop a little bit here. But what we really want to go do is just go into good old... Chrome that needs my there was some flashy dashy things going on there, and there are some extensions update, and I need to move my mic, and there's a lot of things going on here today. Let's just there's also updates. Let's look at that later on. I haven't booted into this VM in way too long. Let's do good old DistroTube, or not DistroTube, DistroWatch. Ubuntu is pointless. Let's go into search. Let's go based on. And let's do, where do we have the Ubuntu? It's all the way down here. Let's just take Ubuntu. Don't want to translate it. We have 54 distributions. That's on the list, official list in DistroWatch that's based on Ubuntu. What if we take Ubuntu LTS? Okay, a lot of the same ones comes out. 19, there probably are some that are in one and not the other. So let's just say 60. 60 distributions that are heavily based on Ubuntu in DistroWatch database. And they have 900 active distributions here. They have 273 active distributions, and 60 of those are Ubuntu or Ubuntu based. That's just in here, not to talk about all of the community done distributions out of the distributions that are on the waiting list and evaluation list and stuff like that. So alone by that metrics makes Ubuntu relevant. Let's look at Ubuntu's website. Ooh, they want to talk about Active Directory. That makes them kind of really relevant. Let's look at their... do they have a partner? Well, let's look at their technologies that they're doing here. OpenStack, Kubernetes, Internet of IoT devices, support services, cloud, containers, data centers, Mars, Multiclock, Ubuntu Server Docs, AI, and ML, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. You know, they are doing a lot of specific stuff here. You can get certified hardware, developers, you can see push app, make devices, community, the ethos. I hate that something has an ethos, but yeah, hey, that is download. Let's go back to Ubuntu here. You can see these are the partners they are working with. Would AT&T work with Ubuntu if it's pointless? Would these work with Ubuntu if it's pointless? Netflix, Uber, Spotify, Walmart, BT, Deutsche Telekom, Rubberbank, Best Buy, Bloomberg, Google Cloud, Intel, ARM, Dell, Nvidia, Intel. Oh, now we're talking about Nvidia. Nvidia open source. Canonical and SUSE can immediately package the open source kernel module with Ubuntu and OpenSUSE Linux Enterprise. I actually thought the Red Hat was in there. So what this means is that Nvidia, that are just open sourcing their industrial drivers, are saying that we officially support SUSE and Ubuntu, not Red Hat, not Fedora, not Arch, not any other distribution. That's, they are not officially support. That don't mean, let me clarify, that don't mean that they won't work on it. Just means that Nvidia is not going to make sure that the open source drivers is working with Arch. The community can do that. They can take the source code and, they can mess around with it. They don't support Arch out of the box. It's the same with Steam. Steam is only officially supported, I think, for Ubuntu. But that, we all know we could run Steam on almost any fucking distribution. It just means that compatibility with the distribution you like is probably done by the community, meaning that the community is repackaging Steam so it works under your favorite distribution. So don't see this as, oh my god, NVIDIA is not going to work under Arts or Solus. Of course it will, but it just means that they don't officially support other distributions other than Ubuntu and SUSE. So Ubuntu being pointless, this is saying something different. If we should believe this, like a big massive corporation that have been anti-open source for this long is by default supporting Ubuntu and SUSE, but not Red Hat. I think there's some literature out there where they say they also will support Red Hat. It may be down here, later down here. Let's look at Ubuntu. Here is some of the some projects we care about. Canonical owns owns Ubuntu. So these are the projects that they are more than likely are supporting or developing or helping. Debian, OpenStack, Juju, Mir, Open Input, Launchpad, CloudInit, Vizar. A lot of this are their own technologies. Debian is of course not. We have here the Ubuntu desktop team, maintenance. Keep up to, we do this. The first and most important task of Ubuntu desktop teams is maintaining our desktop packages, so the GNOME desktop and stuff like that. We do this by keeping up to date with the latest release from our upstream, tearing and fixing reported bugs, testing the desktop, so they are working with the GNOME developers to actually make GNOME better. So Ubuntu is pointless. Ubuntu is let me say it like this. If you're running any other distribution than Ubuntu, you are benefiting from something that Ubuntu have done with some of the software. If you're running the GNOME desktop, you're utilizing Ubuntu fixes and code in your GNOME desktop, even if you're not running Ubuntu. If you're running the Linux kernel, you probably are running fixes and stuff that Ubuntu have done to the kernel. Hardware, they're really big into hardware support. So if you're running anything other than Ubuntu, you are benefiting from Ubuntu's work. All these independent distributions, even to some extent Arts. I don't know how much Arts give back to the community, to be honest. I have to research that one day. But especially small, you know, independent distribution makers, you're only benefiting from their work if you run that distribution, where they are benefiting from what Ubuntu, Red Hat, and SUSE is doing. And I say Red Hat / Fedora, of course. Those are the big hitters. Debian, Red Hat, Fedora, Ubuntu, and SUSE / OpenSUSE. These are the big daddies. You know, these are the fucking... They are slapping everyone around with their pimp hands within Linux. You cannot use Linux or most open source software without benefiting from something those three companies, organizations have done. If that makes Ubuntu pointless, I don't know what fucking thing he puts in his crack pipe, to be honest, but it makes no fucking sense. If you're running a non-Ubuntu distribution and you are benefiting from things Ubuntu is doing, it makes it really fucking relevant, okay? It makes it really, really relevant. You may not like the Ubuntu desktop. You may not like snap packages. You may not like the, you know, the packets of Ubuntu. But you're still benefiting heavily from what Ubuntu is doing to Linux and open source. Just like Red Hat is doing, and Fedora is doing, and SUSE and OpenSUSE and Debian is doing. Those are the people that, if all of those, if Debian went away, OpenSUSE went, or SUSE went away, and OpenSUSE, Ubuntu, Fedora, and Red Hat went away, that would be 95% of the Linux development effort. Probably not, but let's say 90. We're not talking about the kernel, because I think Huawei is like the biggest fucking kernel submitter at the moment, but open source projects. So if one of those goes away, you will really feel it right away. Like, you will fucking feel it so fast. If all of them went away, it will slow development within Linux and open source projects down a fucking lot. You cannot run a Linux distribution and free and open source software today without using stuff that those four organizations have done for the community. I will guess it's almost impossible to do that. And if that's the case, that makes all of them massively relevant within Linux and open source, even if you don't like them. because without them, you will not have, you'll probably not have the bug fix that you have right now. You'll probably not have the hardware capability you have right now. You'll probably not have the speed of the development that you have right now. So many things you could not be having right now if they went, if one of those went away, or if all of those four organizations went away. That alone makes them massively relevant. So saying Ubuntu is pointless, even saying the Ubuntu desktop is pointless, even saying Ubuntu as a home operating system is pointless, it's like saying SUSE, OpenSUSE is pointless, Debian is pointless, Red Hat Fedora is pointless. Because it's part of the big daddies, you know. They are part of the OG crowd. Ubuntu is part of the core Linux ecosystem that will hinder Linux a lot without them. I kind of want to try what he's putting in his crack pipe once in a while, because it must be a fucking crazy, wonderful world that he's living in. See you all later. Bye-bye.